All I'm holding on to my daydream, smoking on some OG. Well, I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on to my love, my love. Oh, she acting like she don't know me. Baby girl, I'm that OG, 'cause I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on to my love, my love. Good morning, good morning. I always say good morning, good morning, good morning. Hunter's making some breakfast. We are drinking some coffee. I'm drinking coffee, and I just made Hunter some ginger lemon water. We did hot water, a little bit of our ginger shot that we made, and a half a lemon.
The breakfast I'm making is, I'm doing lobster with egg. Very bougie. With a little bit of truffle.
Is that truffle cheese?
Truffle pecorino.
You're kidding. I didn't know we had that. And Goose is here, being a stalker. And we love you, Izzy. You're our baby. The light's this way, so I'm gonna switch the camera. Always gotta find that light, bruh. This is the thing with breakfast. We had it the other day. I'm not a huge breakfast person. I'll just like eat lunch around like 12 or something. And I'll have like a coffee. And for some reason, I'm just not a huge breakfast gal, because if I eat breakfast, it gears up my metabolism where I will eat double the amount of food in the day. So at this point, if I start eating breakfast, I'll gain weight because I'll just
You're eating more calories.
Yeah.
All right, I'm trying the ginger lemon in my Land Rover mug that some friends got me, and that is the license plate of the first Land Rover.
Oh, it's the first one?
Yeah. Cool. Anyways.
That's so thoughtful. Wasn't bad. Isn't that good?
Oh, it's freaking amazing.
That should be your drink.
It is my drink.
I just made it.
I know. Thank you.
I
knew lemon water, but I'm glad you added the ginger.
I know.
Because
I love you.
All right, y'all. So, because Julia doesn't want any breakfast, I'm gonna go ahead and let her take the first bite.
You know how you might. Do you want salt?
There's already a little salt in the eggs, but yeah, sure, add some salt.
I mean, I was just asking, you don't have to do it.
Okay. This, here. Here you go.
Try the first bite. It's yours, it needs to know.
No.
No, I need you to know. You
stop,
to tell me.
Stop.
No, I want your rating first.
I want your rating. Your rating's what matters.
It's rich, it's good. That's a gourmet breakfast, Goose.
Mm.
Delish. You love your lobster.
Mm.
Okay.
Tonight, we're making...
Are you gonna do the carbonara?
No, it's like, we're gonna do more of like a creamy Alfredo.
Yes.
With lobster.
I am going live tonight with Windsor at 5. I can't forget.
I'll make dinner.
So we're making margaritas.
But...
We have enough stuff. I had to start doing that, leaving things out. Or I'll forget them. Because I don't have any dumb jokes today. You shouldn't let him do that.
So we've been really into like this Bud Light gelato lately. It's like a really good morning wake up. I'm just kidding. This is for the other night. I don't think you like micheladas, babe.
I don't think I do either.
You said
I would. I liked it, and I thought about it a little longer. I think I would maybe drink it like if I had it.
I bet if we homemade it, it would be good.
I know, that's what people were saying, and I think that if like let's say I had eaten like a lunch, and then it was a happy hour at like 6, and you're kind of like hungry, and then you need like a good cold happy hour drink. That would be a good like happy hour drink.
I don't know though. I don't think it would be, because it's like so salty.
Yeah, it's quite flavorful, but I think it definitely would taste way better if you made it at home. You know, for sure. So, I don't know. Let's figure it out. Working on the night shift, baby. Woo. Because are you ready to play Frisbee? Oh my God. I think you're ready.
So we used to play Frisbee all the time.
Or like, did we use these with someone? And I was like,
I think so. It was when we were living in Mill Valley.
They're like the best Frisbees. I was like, these are awesome. The best. I want some. And I bought a bunch of them.
When we lived in California.
In California, like 3 years ago.
We used to play Frisbee a lot. We'd play it with Goose. Wait, let me grab my coffee. And he loves chasing Frisbees. He's not really a ball chaser. Oh boy. But anyways, yesterday, we, for some reason, remembered the Frisbees. And we were like, the Frisbees. We got to get those out of the garage. And we got them out. And look at him. He loves it. You love a Frisbee. Honey? Goosey. Good job. That is so talented. Got these really cute shorts I saw at Walmart yesterday in the men's section. I was actually, here we go. I went to Walmart to get sweatpants to cut into shorts, but they only had sweat shorts actually at Walmart. So these are men's, they're tie-dye, and they were really long, and I just cut them to like the length of kind of like my boohoo sweats. They're literally like $8, so cute, and then I'm just wearing them with like a sports bra, and this is from like Topshop. Princess Polly has these, Boohoo has these, like any sort of tee, but how cute are they? Aren't they cute? They're like that 90s style short, sweat short that's kind of in right now, and they're a little bit longer, which is the best DIY ever. So I got some other pairs. I'm gonna do a little DIY loungewear in, good morning, later on in the vlog, showing you guys all the stuff I got from Walmart.
All right, we're gonna go on our walk. We're not taking you because people don't like it, so. I'm just kidding. We're gonna take you on with this. You ain't never too much shining, no rush now. You got me wondering if I'm ever gonna come down. And if you're the sun, then I'll be too sun. And you can be down on me. You can be down on me. And I've been on the road.
He loves being dried. Okay, I think you're good, baby.
Still licking himself.
All right, hey everybody. So we actually have been getting a lot of questions about our kitchenware, some of the things we use around the house, kitchen, all that good stuff.
Yeah.
So we figured we would film it and then just drop it in today's video. So here we go.
One of the things we notice in the comments on YouTube the most, in DMs the most, is like, where'd you get that cup? Where are your wine glasses from? So we kind of wanted to walk through our top used barware,
yeah,
dishware.
We'll probably do like another video where like all full kitchen stuff. And we'll also for sure do another video of our barware, stuff I used to make cocktails and all that stuff. We have a few things, but not everything. We'll show you more of that later. But for this one, just the main things y'all are asking about, some of the main things that we use just in the kitchen.
Yeah.
And
probably like our top 10.
Like on a regular basis, yeah.
Okay, starting from morning time, I would say number one is the glass mugs. We're obsessed with these. They're double walled, so they don't like get your hands hot.
I love the clear
and they're
glass.
Aesthetic.
They're so nice. Aesthetic.
We've seen a lot of y'all buy these recently too.
Yeah. So all these will be linked in the description below. So those are first. Also, we get a lot of questions on these mugs. These are actually from a boutique in California called Hudson Grace.
Yep. It's in Larkspur Landing, right?
Yeah, I don't know if they have an online thing, so we will try to
link
them.
We'll check it.
If
so, we'll link it below.
But. Yeah, we'll put the info of the store below.
Next, we have these beer glasses. A lot of y'all have been asking about these on Instagram. These are actual beer glasses, but we got them to drink our regular, like, everyday drinks out of, like, whether it's ice water, smoothies, coffees, obviously beer as well. We even do, like, we had Greyhounds in these last night. So they're just, like, good glasses.
They're just, like, a nice size, and they kind of, like, have that little lip at the top.
Yeah,
and they're just
edge cute. Rim.
Apparently, they have, like, a more affordable version at Target, but
these are still affordable. They're, like, I think two bucks a piece or something like that.
Yeah, we got these from Crate and Barrel, and we like the glassware there. It just looks more modern and refined. So, yeah.
And then the other main glass we use on a regular basis are these.
Yes.
These are our main. Are just like our water cups or, you know, whatever. Drinking glass.
Probably the number one asked about. And these are, I can't remember, right? Williams-Sonoma or Crate and Barrel. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, they're Williams-Sonoma.
Either or, so we'll link them.
Williams-Sonoma.
I would get a glass of 10, but they're really nice, like thin, and they just look chic.
Yeah.
Okay, wine glasses are definitely a big one that we always get asked about. And
this is actually a set, I think.
I'm super picky about wine glasses. And these, I really like the shape of them. They're just like the perfect shape. So here's the red wine glass.
Red wine, white wine, and champagne.
Yes. And I just like how they have the little bend.
Yeah. Obviously the red wine glasses should be like a little bit thicker, wider. White wine is like just kind of your normal standard wine glass size.
I love the shape. I just feel like it's a little more modern than like the rounded, but it's not too square. I don't like the super square ones, so it's a nice fusion.
Yeah, they're all the same style.
Yeah. They're all the same like family of style glasses, so they have glassware different styles, like a round, and you can get round in champagne.
Yeah, you might can find a set of them together, but it's all the same like family or brand or whatever.
Family of glasses.
Okay, moving on to a couple more barware things. So these are more like our whiskey glasses. They're also a cocktail glass, but I'd say mostly margaritas and whiskeys is probably what we drink out of here.
But these are like, what's really cool is they give that fun crystal look, and we've been to like craft bars in San Francisco, and I think we were in Charleston, and they had this barware too, and I looked at the bottom and I remember seeing they were Crate and Barrel, so I bought them myself. But like a lot of like cocktail bars that are really modern use these, so it's really fun to have them at your
house. Kind of has an old, like, it's modern, but it has
like
that
a vintage
old school
vibe.
Vintage vibe, exactly, like
really
the
cool
old Frank Sinatra cocktail bars.
Yeah, like really cool for drinks.
To match those, actually I bought these are like shot glasses that we sometimes like taking ginger shots out of, stuff like that. And I just like these online. Like, if you're gonna have a shot glass, figured like wanna have some nice looking ones.
There are other favorites that you guys see us use all the time, and people are always like, where did you get those? So these are also Crate and Barrel. They're not technically a shot glass. They're basically like a mini dish, but they're basically a double shot glass.
I think you get them in the barware though. They're like double shot glasses.
Yeah.
But we use them mostly for like dipping sauces and stuff like that.
And for sometimes cocktails. They're aesthetic, it's important. All right, next item we want to show, this is not glassware, but this knife we got from my sister for our wedding, I think. And it is from Amazon, which is amazing.
It's the best knife that we have. And it's the knife we, any wedding we go to, this is like the gift we bring.
I know, which somebody has said that you're not supposed to, it's like bad luck to give somebody a knife for their wedding present, but what? I don't care. It's very practical. And a good knife in the kitchen will change the cooking game. You guys, you need a sharp knife. It's a Japanese knife. It's like, I think $70, so a little pricey, but it's worth every penny.
So
we have this one. We need to get a new one, actually.
I bought a sharpener so we can sharpen it.
Okay, yeah, but it's incredible. You will not regret this.
Yeah, I don't believe in that stuff anyways.
I know.
We get it for every wedding.
And people are fine.
People are fine. They're still married. They're in love. Some of the best couples we've ever been around. That knife is keeping them together.
That's right. These bowls you guys see us use all the time. I've talked about them before, but in California, I went to Blue Barn, which is like a really yummy organic
one in downtown,
farm to table,
or in Morgan.
And they had these bowls in their salads, and I looked at the bottom, just Googled them, found them on Amazon. So I love them. They're the perfect size for a salad bowl, and they're amazing. We use them practically every day.
And you got the bigger version of them as well.
Yeah, bigger, which you can use
mixed
for
salads, or I use them for like pasta sometimes.
Yeah.
By the way, y'all should just do that. If y'all ever find something you like at a restaurant or a store, like hopefully you are like know to just check out the brand bottom or something like that and Google it.
We did that. We never found those one glasses at that.
I know. At
farm.
Farm shop?
Farm. Is it called Farm Shop? Farm? Yeah. Best cocktail farm glasses. Shop,
what's that place called?
In Lexington Landing.
It's called the Farm Shop?
Yeah. Is it?
Yeah. Those glasses.
Yeah, they're that's awesome
like,
glasses.
I used to drink Greyhounds out of them. And they're like bowl glasses.
They're really cool. And we literally asked the manager. We're like, can we talk to the manager? We're like, where are these glasses
They're
from?
A Scandinavian brand. And yeah, they only sold to them. Restaurants.
Yeah. But it's fun to like get inspiration from restaurants and then bring that to your house, and it just feels way more like fun and cool, especially when you have guests over.
Or when you like travel. Yeah. Like we get a lot of like our ideas for buying glasses or things we use around the house based on places we go. I know. We're so excited to travel again. Lastly on here, last barware thing we use a lot when we're just like making cocktails is a shaker as well as a strainer. I think they came together, if not, we'll link both of them, but I think it's necessary to have when you're making cocktails at home, especially with like fresh fruit juices that we do a lot.
Yeah.
It's good to have one of these.
Hunter's
with
the cocktail bartender and
I use it just about every time we make a drink. So it's just good to have these things.
Yeah, good to have aesthetic glasses, and all of these we chose very specifically. So you want nice styles. It really makes a difference. Just even drinking your water, having like a nice glass. It's not like, you know.
Yeah, at some point down the road, like I mentioned, we'll get into more of our barware stuff. Like we have even more like different types of beer glasses for like IPAs versus like lagers versus, you know, stuff like that. So we have like, we can go into more details there if y'all are interested, but that's really our basics that we use every day.
Yeah, so they'll all be linked below. Let us know what other things you guys have questions about or are interested in, and we can think up of a full video that we can do to answer all of your staff questions. So let us know.
Totally. Hope you enjoy the rest of the vlog.
Okay. So remember when I started the laundry like a couple vlogs ago? Well, totally just didn't finish it. This has been like throwing my life, because I feel like quarantine's kind of like you just wear like the same comfy things over and over again, and like, I don't know. I mean, I'm washing like my workout clothes, but I've just been like avoiding laundry. I don't know why. So I feel like it's just gotten so backed up. I've got a full hamper here, big pile on the ground, and it's time to address the laundry situation. So I need to fold, and there's nothing like having all your laundry done. So
when you're miles from a nice warm bed.
Put on a podcast. I'm gonna play a podcast. Let's see. I love the Skinny Confidential. Him and her podcast. They are like couple goals.
The following podcast is a Dear Media production. She's a lifestyle blogger extraordinaire.
Fantastic.
And he's a serial entrepreneur.
A very smart company.
And now Lauren Everts and Michael Bostick are bringing you along for the ride.
Get ready for some major realness.
Welcome to the Skinny Confidential.
So everything's hung to dry. I've got all my next loads in here. I linked this hamper in a previous vlog. I'll try and link it again. Drying, washing, hung and folded. Hunter needs to go through all this stuff because this is like stuff that he probably doesn't need anymore. So yeah, that's progress. Also, I'm listening to the Skinny Confidential episode, and it is so good. I mean, honestly, all of their episodes are really good, but this one's really good. It's about like how kind of getting out of a funk, especially if you're in a funk during like quarantine right now, and how to kind of like build your confidence back and like kind of get yourself going again, and like setting goals and just being better. It's called Happiness is Knowing You're Not Okay. The Him and Her podcast. And I'll try and link it if I can remember, but it's really good, especially they just talk about like always having goals and progressing, even if it's like little areas. It doesn't have to be like success or anything, but just like health or relationships or whatever, stuff like that. It's like basically everything Hunter and I like always think about, just like always moving forward and like progressing and stuff. So yeah, it's really good. I feel like it's like articulating everything that like I've always like thought. So you guys should listen to it. Okay, I am gonna just tidy up a little bit and plan out my schedule for the rest of the day. I'm gonna do a leg day workout and yeah. Just got a very exciting package in the mail that I wanted to share, and it is some new jewelry pieces from Lily Clasp, which is my favorite jewelry brand, probably up there, my top three. You guys know I'm just like a jewelry fanatic, so I love Miranda Fry's pieces, I love Lily's pieces, and they're all really different vibes, like none of them are the same. So that's what's cool, is like getting your stuff from a different jewelry people. It's just like getting your stuff from different stores. So I love like mixing and matching everything and all the different brands. But what I like about them and what's consistent across all of the jewelry brands that I love are that they are a really nice, I think, medium price point that's not so expensive that you literally can't afford it. And it's not fine jewelry, but it's, you know, kind of anywhere between $50 and $100-ish dollars per piece. And they really last, like you can wear them for a few years before they start to kind of like tarnish, and wear them every day. Technically, you can like shower with these pieces on, like I know a lot of you guys ask that, but you can, but they will tarnish faster if you shower with them on. So I don't shower with any of my jewelry on, I don't sleep with it on, nothing, because I like it to last and stay shiny, but that happens with any pieces. So even if you buy fine jewelry, over time you have to get it polished again. It's just kind of like shoes or something, like they dull out and you have to get them, you know, cleaned. Handbags, jewelry, same thing. So anyways, I just think these are some of the best quality for the price, and the styles are so modern and pretty, like I love them. So she sent me a few pieces from her new collection, which launched last week, from her spring 2020 collection. And this herringbone chain that I wear literally every day, you guys already know, is from her. If you follow on Instagram, I tag like all of my jewelry and like close details over there. If you want like everyday kind of updates, you guys can look there. But so the new additions are this really cool herringbone chain. It's kind of like a V shape and it has a moonstone here. There's also like a darker stone option, but I love this. I think it looks super cool paired together. And then she also sent me this tennis necklace, which is so cool. It's has like, you know, I think they're like CZs or something, but it's gorgeous and it adds just like a little bit of shine. And this one's like a nice shorter length, so you can like layer it with the other one. So this one I think comes in only one length. This is the Reggie thick in 18 inches. And then this is the tennis necklace and this is 15 inches. She also sent me these little tusk earrings. They are so cute, they're pave. I love them, very my vibe. Just add them to my stack. These are also from her. Which I wear already every day. I love these earrings. And then lastly is this little ring that is like a V-shaped pave with a moonstone. I love the moonstone additions. Like, I just feel like it's super cool and gives like a little bit of a boho vibe mixed with 90s. Like, it's a really cool combination. So I just love her. I think she's so talented and I love all of her jewelry. So thank you so much. And I have a code, it's Julia15 for 15% off. If you guys want to get anything from there, I would highly recommend getting like a chain or a ring to wear every day. Her stuff is so good. And I wear this nonstop every day. It's like the cutest thing ever and it just looks good with everything. So that's my little jewelry haul. Also, totally broke the other camera this morning when I was working out. I think you guys saw it, probably like fell. Oh, and I put on makeup too, if you're wondering, like, whoa. But it's really hot in my room right now. That's why I have on my sports bra. I'm sweating. I need to go turn on the AC, but yeah, but luckily we had a backup camera, so that's what I'm on right now. I didn't tell Hunter that the camera broke. He's not gonna be happy, but that's why we have backup cameras, just in case this type of situation goes down. Sweating. Okay, he is on the phone. I have to get to editing a video, and then I'm going live on Windsor's Instagram tonight to make margaritas with everybody. So I need to put up a little reminder on my story so you guys can come join the live. But I'm gonna finish up some work before then, and then I'll see you guys tonight. I have caught up on work, and sorry, this lighting's so bad. I just changed for my Windsor live because I just wanted to put on like a little bit of normal clothes versus loungewear, even though I was really comfortable in what I had on, but just trying to dress for the occasion. So these are my A Goldie shorts. This top is obviously Windsor. I've worn it a ton on my Instagram. I love this top. It's a really nice quality for the price. It feels like the most buttery, soft thing ever, and it's just really, really cute with like high-waisted denim. As you can see, it's kind of like a simple top with like a little twist, no pun intended, literally a twist. So I have all the stuff ready for margaritas. Let me show you. And it's gonna be like a lot of you guys, but also people from Windsor's account. So let's see here. Got all my stuff set up, and I'm gonna set up my phone on the tripod here. Okay, I think I'm ready. I just need to get some ice and start juicing my fruits, and then we're going live. Alrighty. Got all the margarita stuff out. If you guys have, for some reason, I think most of you have seen our margarita recipe. We have a special margarita recipe. It's on my IGTV, but here's all the ingredients, and I'm about to make them on the live as well. But it's on there, saved and everything. So if you, you know, somehow missed it, you can go there to bookmark it and refer back, but it's really good, so. Say hello. Hi, this is the Windsor Live. Later, we are grilling some hot dogs for dinner. These are grass-fed, we found at the store. I'm gonna do some spicy brown mustard on mine. It's the best. Got some raw onion, that's gonna go on it. I want it like ballpark style, you know? Good vibes, summer vibes.
Something I learned from the Texans.
Goose, that is so adorable. I don't even know what to do with myself. It's so cute. He loves to burrow. And I made this little chin rest for you, so I built up the blanket so that you could put your chin on that. And that feels really good, doesn't it? That's what I thought. I love you. Let's put your ears out. Your ears need to be out. There we go. This is so good.